check charts today and tomorrow. 10 o'clock for your big call. The schedule is over here. Today we've got a couple of folks in the building reassembly plan. They're going to talk to you a little bit about our new paint job that's going in. You probably heard about that. So the major and that's going to be them and the building reassembly plan, as well as the my left, Kai Spande, is our plant manager from Bowling Green, and Bill Gillespie is the area manager for General Assembly, which is basically the turbine chassis, as well as the Performance Build Center, which is where we build the LG Corvette. So we're going to talk a little bit about the paint shop, and then feel free, we'll have some time for questions after that. Feel free questions about the paint shop or anything about the Bowling Green facility. I'll put in a plug while I'm here for the tours. If you have not been to the plant and done the tour, it's an excellent tour. It'll really give you just an excellent idea how the Corvette goes together. So I encourage you to do that.
Hi, how are you?
Okay, so can everybody hear okay? No?
No, I'm back here.
Listen better then.
It's already gone.
Okay. Who has been in the plant? As a raise. Okay, so almost maybe half. And has anybody been in the plant in the last year? Almost maybe a little bit less. So what I'd like to do today is to, we can have a little bit of interaction. We've got maybe 10 or 15 minutes. I'll be open for any questions. And Bill, he actually has the majority of the manufacturing operations he is responsible for. So, you know, he sees a lot of stuff in the plant. I know what's going on in the plant. And so while the idea of the discussion is to talk about the new paint shop, if you have a question, I'll give you an answer. But a little bit about the paint shop, just facts and figures for you. We are in the process for the last year and a half building the new paint shop. Right now, everything, if you are in the construction, would be referred to as dried in. So all of the roof and side panels are on. And structural work is all done. Last week we finished all of the interior concrete, and it's almost a half a million square feet, which you might wonder why it's so big, and I'll get to that, some of the improvements that we'll have with the new paint job. But also, a lot of the equipment is in place, set in place, and a lot of these are, you know, the ovens, the paint booths, all of this infrastructure, and then you bring in conveyor systems that will move the eventual box or the piece of equipment that we use to hold the panels through the paint shop. And that's all on track for the very, very, very first depot starting in the early part of next year. And then as we go through the summer, you know, we have to what I refer to, have a sunset and a sunrise, because we will not just be able to flip the switch and all cars will come be painted out of the new paint shop. So the first color that will come out of the new paint shop will be white. It'll be a color that will also be co-produced in the existing facility. And then as we, you know, knowing that every color needs to have its own process developed, every color paints a little bit different. So everyone has to be done independently. And also due to the fact that we don't paint all of the parts. The mirrors aren't painted. If you get a V92 hood, the exposed carbon fiber, we don't paint that hood. It comes to us painted. And roofs come to us painted. As do spoilers. A lot of the work that we have to do is make sure that everything matches so that when you look at the car, you can't tell. So all that work needs to happen. The first color will be white, and then we'll merge through all the colors that we have. And as you know, we have 10 colors at any given time. Way back in the corner, we have the black rose, which is starting up just this week in our existing shop. And again, you know, just in a short period of time, we run the black rose. And then we have, again, what I refer to as the sunset, try to figure out how we take the old plant down and bring the new plant up. So it'll be exciting. If you ask the question, well, when are we going to see cars that are going to come out of the new shop? That'll be into the fall of next year. So when you think about the magnitude of what it takes, not just the money to build this paint shop, it's almost $350 million. It's an investment, and due to that, you know, there's a lot of processes that have to go on to start up correctly. But for sure, you know, the things that are going to go on in the new shop are going to make the product much, much better. Right now, the company, North America, we have the oldest paint shop in operation making this car. And we also have the sort of best paint people in the company making what we have as good as it can possibly be. And when we have this new facility come online, everything will kind of happen. If anybody's there, I'm just learning, being new to Kentucky, learning how to smoke and barbecue stuff. When you do that, you want low and slow, right? That's what this car does. So because of the composite nature of the components that are on the SMC and the carbon fiber, they don't like heat. Normal paint processes like to be painted, and then you can heat them up, and that was part of the curing process. If you heat the plastics, the SMC is the carbon up too much, what happens is that the plastic will actually erupt through the paint, and that's bad. So we have to bring the temperatures down. We have to increase the time that they're in those ovens, and that's one of the main reasons why the facility is going to be so large, because we want the process to be enabled to have low temperatures for a long time on the multi-steps that we do that we paint. You know, two primer colors, multiple base coat colors, and then multiple primer or repair coats. And in the case of some parts, they have a 10-foot to be So that's a real nutshell of what's going on in the paint shop. And I invite, I'm not trying to predict what questions people might have. Maybe somebody has a question, so we have somebody here. So that is one of the biggest benefits of the new paint shop is that it will be this team probably cleaner than the surgery. So the new controls in the room, any customer communicating in the shop will be world class. So what you will see is less chances of new corrections, or if we see something, we might have to make the repair. And of course, that's not exactly what you want. You want first time quality, people want to do it right. You don't ever touch it. The fact of the matter is that we do something on a case bill. And that should be in addition, because we can paint the car slower, and we're going to have better, we call it bells, it's the part of the end of the robot that spreads the material paint out onto the car. That's going to bring a much better technology, so we can atomize the paint much better. Again, it's kind of, like I said before, it's kind of like smaller part of what's going on. So the overall appearance should be and will be better. And we've also got a couple of tricks up our sleeves that I'm not going to tell you about because they're proprietary at this point. So we'll even improve the surface tension. Plastic parts of the carbon are difficult to electrostatically charge. Primer actually has some amount of conductivity put into it, but if you paint a panel in this type of an orientation, vertical orientation, the paint doesn't like to stand up. It likes to run down. So again, by putting a smaller part of the time, it will help. Being slower will help. More application will help. And by the way, we're also going to build in some redundancy, so we see the need to make some improvement, extend the time, have another application, we'll have the also, we do 10 colors now. We'll have the ability to do maybe 12 colors. We've got Charles. He wants every color. He wants people to do four colors. That makes me a little dizzy. That's what we're... does that answer your question? All right, try to give you a little background. And that just gives you a yes and no. One here. Yeah, you can order premium colors that have a tint coat. Which is an additive to the current coat that makes the colors come up at a comfortable type of a color. So if you look at the colors that you have, some are premium. And I think it would be a special. Right here. Okay. The question was, repeat the question. So
the question.
The question over here was, what about premium colors?
That's the only one.
And the previous question was, what would we expect for improvements from the old to the new paint job? You know, from an operations standpoint, I'm an operations guy. We're not going to have less people in your paint shop. It's going to be a big capital investment. And if you run the numbers, it costs a lot of money per car to put cars through this new facility. So, and we're not going to save money on the people that have to do work in that facility. A lot of work still has to, because the nature of the car kind of has to be done by hand. So the investment is going to simply be a better product for our customers. That's what it is.
And now I have your attention. If you see this every day, what are the two or three big problems that you see with the case now that you don't see? Orange peel, fish eye, what do you see on the problems?
Yeah, so the question, I'll repeat the question. I learned, what are the big things that you see now that will be improved upon? And that probably goes back to the answer to the first one. The green is in the paint that has to be repaired. Or in the case that we never want to have paint this happen, but I would be naive to, and I know that it does happen, some is out of the plant. So by eliminating that is a huge step up. And then by the way that we apply the paint, we will have a better overall finish. So it'll look smoother and it'll be less. The paint has to take the term orange paint, but it's a surface for them. And the limits are orange paint, but we'll have less of that.
Because, listen, about 3 years ago, when C-7 came in this town, one of the engineers said, you know, all the improvements, and what he said was, those of you who are unhappy with our paint, you're still going to be unhappy, because nothing we can do at that point to paint fiberglass or the same way as you do now. I guess
well, yeah, and maybe to repeat the question, will we have world-class show quality custom paint? You know, I've got an old street drive. The paint job on my street drive is probably $15,000. In an automated process, you are not going to get mirror flat surface on the paint. You just won't. Go look at any production car, and we will be very good. But when you get to that point, you're talking about, you know, 50, 60, 70 hours of hand sanding that isn't going to be part of the process. That's a good point of clarification. What will you improve, and where won't you go? Because with the market that we cater to, there's people that want to show quality paint, and these individuals don't end up getting the product. Anything else? Another question? Okay, so the question is, what's the production rate for the new facility? And will we do anything else, any other cars? So the production rate will match what we do now, but what we have now, we have an operation that runs 1.5 shifts. It's really 2 shifts, but the 2nd shift is condensed. It's not a full crew. Our plan in the future is to run 2 full shifts. And that simply gets to what I refer to as capital utilization. If you pay to buy, if you buy something that can process very fast, you're going to pay a lot of money. We have the time, so we're going to stretch that out. And we'll build an inventory on the 2nd shift, and then we'll consume those parts the following day. Simply to take that huge investment and reduce it. The flexibility that we'll have in this paint shop, it's all paneled off, right? So it's the only, the thing about Bowling Green is that it's really the only shop that does paneled off. It's the only shop that does these composites. It's by color. So if I have white representing 20% of the total volume, that means that I'm going to make 8,000 of these cars every year. The development, I guess I get paid 8,000 pounds. If I do one new color, it's probably $200,000 just for the development. Yeah. But if you know why, I think it's fair. It's all waterborne, and our technology in this paint shop will also go beyond just waterborne. We will have dry scrubber systems from an environmental standpoint. We won't use waterborne systems, we'll use dry scrubber. So this is technology that's only used in Europe, and basically we reduce the consumption of tens of thousands of gallons of water on a daily basis to move the paint out of the shop. Pulverize limestone, aerate the limestone in the exhaust stream of the paint. The paint is attracted to the limestone, and then we bring that out and it goes into a dry collector. That's a very easy description of what we're going to do to eliminate water. And it's just, it's used actually by one of our competitors, Ford, making trucks in Louisville. So it's not new in the world, it's used in Europe and China. In the United States, we'll be second car. We'll be first GM car.
Want to use the limestone from under the museum?
Yeah, so the question is, we could use the limestone. No, that's all we're in the sinkhole at the museum. Okay, maybe one more question, and then we'll wrap it up. And what I would really appreciate if you give Phil a question. Or I'll ask for a tough question.
Look at this.
So the question is, are there going to be tours in the new shop? So the answer is yes. So that has been part of the design. So we are in the process of trying to set up where you can actually see a portion of the paint shop. Now, clearly you're not going to be able to go into an oven area, but you will be able to see cars go through a certain part of the paint shop. Anything else? Yes, non-club, yeah, absolutely, whatever you got. The answer is probably no, but go ahead and ask.